I guess I'll talk in English. First of all, I need to say that from a structural point of view, talking, being the last speaker of this session is of some value, because I'm going to put the discussion, I'm going to go one step behind, because everyone has been talking about very wonderful and very interesting applications. I'm going to talk about infrastructure and how can we make this application flourish in the MyData infrastructure. So, my name is Alexandros Nousias. I'm a lawyer, I'm a legal guy. My background is in IP, intellectual property and privacy, and I currently work also as an ethics advisor and data protection officer in European projects and organizations. Here I come with my GFOS hat. GFOS is an organization, it's an NGO, more or less, let me see. More or less, it has been established in 2008, in operation since 1996. The important number is that we are comprised from 35 universities and research centers, and we have many working groups, scientific committees, and a still evolving community of 9,000 members, originally coming from the open source software community. So our main objective is to promote openness. We like open, and we like to promote openness in education, public administration, and business. And it may allow me to make myself clear here. When we're talking about open, we're not talking about free as free beer. So it's the concept are slightly different. Because openness, and this is very important for the MyData infrastructure I'm going to talk in a while, openness is very important because it highlights the extinction of barriers to entry, legal and technical barriers to entry of some, let's say, applications. So, what we're talking about today is more or less the design. The design in the health sector in the past looked like this. It was more or less physical. There was no connectivity, no portability, no mix and reuse. It was, just a second, yeah. It was, yeah, the health sector looked like this, the design looked like this. It was physical, as you may understand. No connectivity, no portability, no mix and reuse. So it was a rather intimate and not perfect way of maintaining ledgers and sharing health data and information. At the moment, and I'm referring to health sector 3.0, because we are living in the Web3 era, where the meaning comes from the automation, the meaning is automated, and the machines are the ones that bring meaning to the words and the human labor and the human operation in general. So health turns digital, and health systems will be decentralized, local and preventive, and the adoption of new technology or infrastructure occurs when there is ease of use, economic savings, and trust. So let's talk about the design. We need to redesign our infrastructure, our data, and our policy. Since I'm a lawyer, I'm mainly focused on the GDPR, the General Data Protection Regulation, and all the privacy issues that come at play when talking about sharing health data. But at the same time, we need also to define the infrastructure of that we operate on. So, when we're talking about improving our health system, more or less we're talking about improving our healthcare data management, or introducing our healthcare data management. I don't want to put you in the legalese. I just want you to keep in mind that according to the GDPR, the General Data Protection Regulation, there is this fantastic definition about personal data, which talks about, which states that personal data means any information related to an identified or identifiable natural person. This means that all data around could turn to be personal data, with all the legal implications that come at play. Of course, the GDPR acknowledges some special categories of personal data, the so-called sensitive data, and genetic, biometric, and data that concern health belong to these special categories. And classifying data in the special categories of personal data has certain legal implications regarding the data subject's rights, regarding the legal basis of processing, and so on and so forth. So I'm not going to the detail of the definition. I just wanted to, I want you to keep in mind that when we're talking about health data in the GDPR, we're talking about, we're also talking about genetic data and biometric data. So the definition and the scope of the health data broadens. In practical terms, putting this into practice, we see some certain types of health data where the GDPR has very certain implications. And this is where the MyData infrastructure will come and chip in. When we're talking about health data, we're talking about subscription in health services and related financial transactions, as was mentioned by the mayor, diagnosis, testing, examinations, results, and all this kind of information, info on disease or risk to disease, disability, medical history, health services of any kind. And this is very crucial, any identifier assigned to uniquely identify an individual for health purposes. This means that all pseudonymized data or even the anonymized data could qualify and classify it as personal data and as sensitive personal data. And bear in mind that when we're talking about these types of health data, this need not to be generated by doctors, but overall health professional. And the overall health sector is quite wide because we're talking about cosmetics, we're talking about physicists, physiotherapists, and all this kind of people. Yeah. So the one crucial point that we need to highlight is the access to health data. There is no particular article in the GDPR regarding access to health data per se. However, Recital 63 includes the right, considers that the data subject should have the right of access to personal data, and this includes the right of for data subjects to have access to data concerning their health. And so this means that they will have access to all the aforementioned types of health data. So putting all these types of health data in place, we're talking about a complete and consistent healthcare data management system. But when we're talking about a consistent healthcare data management system, we need to talk also about privacy. And we need to respect privacy and to preserve privacy in a trustworthy and transparent and open manner. So building our health data management systems, we need to take care in order to have them resilient, effective, accessible, cost-effective, fiscally sustainable, privacy-preserving, and trustworthy. And here comes where MyData, the infrastructure of MyData, chips in. Because MyData takes the view, which is not actually the view of MyData, it's actually it's a fact, that personal data is everywhere. And personal data is an underused raw material for new services due to lack of interoperability and portability between data sets across services and sectors. So the MyData infrastructure, what it really tries to do is to tackle all these limitations among sectors in terms of interoperability and in terms of the capacity and the ability to portability, to the right of portability. There is this this yoga notion that that says that the world, I'm putting it in a very simplistic way, it says that the world is a one, it's a unified, and we humans are living in a symbiotic cosmos illusion, because we're trying to create barriers within the unified one. So we're living in a paradox. And my data vision is trying to put these barriers aside and mitigate all limitations, bring the different data silos together. So the core idea is that individuals should be in control of their data, that all individuals do have digital human rights that we need to respect. However, we recognize the right of enterprises in the 21st century to access personal databases and build on that. The main principles of my data are these three. Keep in mind these three words: human-centric, usability, and open business environment. I could talk for 1 hour or 1 day for each separate principle. I guess I have no time. So let's see a little bit my data in practice. What it does more or less is that it has an infrastructure level approach and ensures that there is data interoperability and portability. It is sector independent and it can work across all sectors, and it seems that health and finance lead the way. What it's very important from a legal point of view is that it's solely and strictly consent-based. The management and control is consent-based. We don't have any other legal basis of processing like the legitimate interest that has been introduced in the GDPR. If anyone is a legal guy or lawyer here, would understand the importance of this differentiation of the MyData infrastructure. Of course, there are many examples of my data. We have an example in my data in occupational health. This slide more or less gives us visualizes the ability of a person in the human in the my data infrastructure to extract data from different datasets and across different sectors in order to, in a way, optimize his medical treatment. The same goes, there are different, many, many examples. My data and loyalty card, which has implications and application in the health sector as well. At this point, I was supposed to present the video, which I'm not. So I'm going to talk a little bit to give you some tweets.
One minute.
I'm talking, you see how fast I'm talking. The tweet and the things that I want you to keep in mind is that privacy in my data is considered as the power to control what others can come to know about you. This is what privacy stands for to date. And allow others to access and use. We need to build on the ethics of my data, which more or less is about human-centric management of personal data, usable and guarantees of autonomous individualism. Keep in mind reciprocities and open business environment, reciprocities, because for the first time there is an infrastructure that allows the individual to somehow monetize the personal data management that takes place on his behalf. Another thing that we need to take into account when we're talking about circulation of health data we need to ask ourselves whether all data is for sale. Or on the contrary, if all personal data should be considered private. This is the visualization of the General Data Protection Regulation. It's a quite complex legal construction. My data comes to simplify things. And if we follow, in our applications follow the My Data declarations and respect the My Data principles, we may create a legal and a technical environment where health data circulation will be more, in a way, relaxed. So at the moment, local hubs are being created around the world. We are attempting to introduce the Greek local hub, and so we are welcoming all of you in order to co-create and to try to explore ways of putting your applications and what you guys do and operating in the MyData infrastructure. Thank you very much.